Hello, this is not the best view. I apologize, I'm not able to edit videos at this time. I want to say a few things about polytheism, the belief in many gods. I'm tired right now, so if I make any mistakes in this video, I apologize. Belief in many gods is on the rise today, and I believe there are two main reasons for this. One is because people generally lack critical thinking skills. Critical thinking was actually removed from the education system. So today, people don't ask questions, they don't test claims, they don't research things, they just believe what they're told in many cases. And also, people are usually ignorant of scripture. So when you have critical thinking removed and ignorance of scripture, the results are going to be disastrous. You're going to see things like polytheism on the rise. Okay. Now, Saint Augustine wrote a book called The City of God, and in it he deals with Roman polytheism. So if you are a pagan, I recommend you read The City of God by Saint Augustine. Whenever I've heard pagans talk about gods, I've never heard a rational defense for the concept of polytheism. They'll talk about their beliefs. They believe in the god and the goddess, but I've never heard them defend the concept of polytheism. I don't think these people have devoted serious intellectual energy into determining whether or not polytheism is rational to believe and defensible. So I'm going to present a basic case against polytheism in this video. I've heard them say that the god and goddess came from the universe. They were formed from the universe. This tells me the god and goddess are finite, contingent, dependent beings. They're not ultimate beings. They don't meet the definition of true deity. They're not true deity. So they came from the universe, which implies that the universe is superior to the god and the goddess. But we now know from scientific evidence and through philosophical argument that the universe is finite, contingent. It came into existence a finite time ago. Philosophical argument would say it's impossible to traverse an infinite number of moments. So if the universe was infinite, then this moment would never have arrived. The scientific evidence supporting the finitude of the past or the finite universe is the second law of thermodynamics, radiation echo, Einstein's theory of relativity, the Borg-Guth-Vilenkin theorem of 2003, the agnostic astrophysicist Robert Jastrow said the radiation echo has convinced almost the last doubting Thomas, end quote. That's from his book, God and the Astronomers. And Stephen Hawking said that most physicists today believe the universe came into existence. Okay, so this is where scientists are at today. There's general consensus that the universe came into existence a finite time ago. Yet, according to polytheistic paganism, the gods came from the universe, something finite, contingent. So we're talking about finite, contingent beings here. And I would like to know how the universe, which came into existence, could produce a god and goddess. It makes no sense. See, in Christianity, the Christian God is the greatest conceivable being. He created the entire universe ex nihilo, out of nothing. And I would argue that modern cosmology supports the biblical teaching that God created the universe. Now, I have some notes I'm going to go through here, and sometimes it's hard for me to read my own writings. I apologize. If the universe produced the gods, then they are not eternal, infinite, or ultimate beings. So there are no good reasons to be devoted to these creatures. And that's what they are. They're creatures. If nature created the gods, then nature is ultimate. Just think about that. Nature would be ultimate, but we now know that nature came into existence a finite time ago. It's not infinite or eternal. It's finite and contingent. If the gods are derivative beings, then they are not worthy of ultimate commitment. Plotinus said all plurality presupposes a prior unity. The reason I said that is because I would argue that the universe suggests monotheism, creation from one being. We live in a universe, not a polyverse. So the personal power behind the universe must be a unity. The anthropic principle says that the universe was fine-tuned at the beginning for the emergence of life. And I would argue that this anthropic principle suggests one designer with one purpose, one purposer from the beginning. Polytheistic gods are within the universe, not beyond it. See, the Christian God is beyond the universe, transcendent. He created the universe out of nothing. As a worldview, polytheism lacks rational and evidential support. There are no good reasons to be a polytheist. No good reasons to believe in many gods. And I would also argue that Occam's razor would go against polytheism. Occam's razor is a principle of reasoning which says all things being equal, the simplest explanation tends to be the right one. It's more simple to posit one god as opposed to many gods. Now, if you are a polytheist, I recommend that you read chapters 1 and 2 of the Epistle to the Romans in the New Testament. Okay? St. Paul talks about how God reveals himself to us in our conscience and in nature. And in the description, I'm going to give some more information against polytheism. And by the way, I forgot to mention, we now know through archaeology that monotheism is older than polytheism. The Ebla tablets furnish evidence for this, for example. 16,000 clay tablets from Syria discovered beginning in 1974 speak of one god. The Ebla tablets date to the 3rd millennium BC, and they contain the oldest creation account outside the Bible, 600 years older than the Babylonian creation account. And the idea that religion evolved from primitive animism to polytheism to henotheism to monotheism is now known to be false. This idea was promoted by James Frazier in his book, The Golden Bough, the late 19th century, but this is now known to be false. We now know monotheism is older than polytheism. So I'll give more information below in the description box.